Good morning to all my 9th class students. I, Ms. Rupali Avare, welcomes you all for this today's session on one of the biology chapter, that is the fundamental unit of life. It is the most interesting topic which we are going to learn today. With this, at the end of this session, you will be able to understand the concepts of cell organelles and the cell division. In the earlier session, we have learned about the concepts related to the main features of the cell, that is the plasma membrane, or it is also known as the cell membrane. Then we have seen the cell wall, which is exclusively present in plant cells. Then we have studied about the nucleus, which plays a very central role in the cell. And then we have seen about the cytoplasm. So, as like in our body, many functions are performed by different organs. Similarly, these cells, they do also different works. So, let us start with the first topic, that is the cell organelle. Now first we'll understand what are these cell organelles, where these cell organelles are present, what is the job of these cell organelles, what is the size of these cell organelles, and which kinds of cell organelles are present in a cell. So as we know that every cell has a membrane bound to keep its own content separate from the external environment. As we have seen in the earlier session that the cell membrane, it divides the content or it separates the content which is present inside the cell from the external environment or from the neighboring cells. We have seen that large and complex cells, including the cells from the multicellular organisms, they need a lot of energy. And they got that energy from the chemical activities which are occurring inside the cell. And these chemical activities to support their complicated structure and the function. To keep these activities of different kinds of separate from each other, and these cells use the membrane bound like structures. As we have categorized the substance organisms based on whether they are having a nuclear membrane or not into eukaryotics and the prokaryotic cells. Similarly, these organelles, they have their own membrane bound structure that makes them separate from the other substances or from the other organelles which are present inside the cytoplasm. And this is the exclusive feature of the eukaryotic cells that distinguishes them from the prokaryotic cells, which has a membrane bound like structures. So some of these organelles are visible only under an electron microscope. As we have seen, the size of a cell is in terms of the micrometer, and obviously these cell organelles, these are the subcellular structures which are present inside the cell, that is inside the cytoplasm. Already one of the major organelle, that is the nucleus that we have studied. So we can say cell organelles is a subcellular structure. They performs one or more specific jobs in the cell, like the creation of the food, digestion of the food, and so on. These are the membrane bound. They have their own membrane which separates them from the other organelles. As we have seen, we cannot see the cells with our naked eyes. We require a high power electron microscope. And obviously, if we need an electron microscope to observe the cell, we also need an electron microscope to observe these cell organelles. All cells have a plasma membrane, then ribosomes, cytoplasm, and DNA. Prokaryotic cells lack a nucleus and membrane-bound structure, whereas eukaryotic cells, they have a nucleus and membrane-bound structures, and these are known as the organelles. Cell organelles are of different types, like the endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, or it is also known as the Golgi bodies, then lysosomes, mitochondria, plastids, and vacuoles. They are very important because each organelle plays a different work. They carry out very crucial functions in the cell and which keeps the cell alive. So let us start with the first cell organelle, that is the endoplasmic reticulum. Now, as we know that inside the cell, many chemical activities are taking place to support the cell, to keep it alive. So cell needs a lot of proteins and lipids, right, to function the cell nucleus, function as a brain. Nucleus is acting as a brain and decides what is needed, how much is needed. And all these materials are manufactured in an organelle, that is the factory for the cell, which is the endoplasmic reticulum. So let us study about the endoplasmic reticulum. Now look at this diagram. This blue color, this outer is the membrane, plasma membrane. Then inside you will see the nucleus, and then these all are the different cell organelles which we are going to study later. And these dots which you see, these are the ribosomes. So first we will see what are these endoplasmic reticulum. So here this green color, these all are the endoplasmic reticulum. So the endoplasmic reticulum, this is a network of tiny tubular structures and sheets which is present inside the cell in the cytoplasm. It is a continuous membrane system that forms a series of flattened sacs in the cytoplasm of the eukaryotic cells. And this serves multiple functions, being important particularly in the synthesis, folding, modification, and transport of protein. And you can see that it looks like a net. Now, why it looks like a net and how that name comes, reticulum. The meaning of the word reticulum in Latin is net-like, and therefore the name is endoplasmic reticulum. Then these endoplasmic reticulum, if you will observe carefully, then that creates a link between the plasma membrane and the cell membrane, as well as it creates a path to transfer some of the substances from one part of the cell to the other part of the cell, as well as it is acting as a channel between different parts of the cytoplasm, also between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Now, there are, if you will see this here, the figure is enlarged. You will see some of the granule structures on this endoplasmic reticulum, and these are known as the ribosomes. Ribosomes, these are the sites of protein synthesis. So these ribosomes or the proteins are synthesized on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum. Then there are two types of endoplasmic reticulums depending on the surface. First is rough endoplasmic reticulum, and another is the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Why we call an endoplasmic reticulum as a rough endoplasmic reticulum? If you will see here on the surface, these granule structures that are the ribosomes are present. So if you will look the endoplasmic reticulum, it looks rough because some particles are present on its surface, or they are attached to the surface, and these are the ribosomes. The ribosomes which are present in all the active cells are the sites of protein manufacture. The manufactured proteins are then sent to the various places in the cell depending on the need using the endoplasmic reticulum. So basically, all the protein is manufactured here in this rough endoplasmic reticulum. And then next is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Why it is called as the smooth endoplasmic reticulum? Because as the granules are present, that are the ribosomes which are attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. In this case, these ribosomes are not attached to the endoplasmic reticulum, and hence they are known as the smooth endoplasmic reticulums. Now, as like the rough endoplasmic has a function of protein manufacturing, these smooth endoplasmic reticulum, they helps in the manufactures of the fat molecules like the cholesterol or lipids, and which are important for the cell to function, as well as they produce the enzymes called as the phospholipids. Now these enzymes are embedded inside the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Some proteins and lipids function as enzyme and hormones in endoplasmic reticulum. Thus, endoplasmic reticulum is also known as the cytoplasmic framework for biological activities. See, then these proteins and lipids which are produced by this endoplasmic reticulum are then sent to the various places depending on the need, and that is known as the biogenesis. The meaning of biogenesis: bio means life and genesis means creation. So wherever it is needed, that is then sent to the other parts inside the cell. Then number of ER, that is endoplasmic reticulum, it varies from cell to cell. Now, for example, consider a liver cells which are present in the animals called as the vertebrates. Now, what is the function of the liver? The function of the liver is detoxification, right? Now, usually toxins are removed from the blood through the urine. But for that, toxins have to be soluble in water. But sometimes it might happen that these toxins are not water soluble. And that's where these endoplasmic reticulums, that are the smooth endoplasmic reticulums, plays a crucial role in detoxifying many poisons and the drugs, or it helps in removing these toxins. Now, the enzymes which are embedded in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, they catalyze the reaction and make these toxins urine soluble, and therefore can be excreted from the body easily. So this is how what we have seen is the major role of the endoplasmic reticulum is acting as a protein manufacturing site, as well as these smooth endoplasmic reticulums that helps in proteins and the lipids, as well as in the process of enzyme synthesis. The next organelle, that is the Golgi apparatus, or it is also known as Golgi bodies. Now, this was first discovered by an Italian doctor known as the Camillo Golgi. Now, these Golgi bodies looks like this. If you will observe, you can say that they have their membrane. So, these are also membrane bound, and it is composed of stacks of membrane, and these are known as the cisternae. Here you can see it. Around by the vesicles. Can you see? These are the vesicles. It processes, packages, and transport various substances like the proteins and lipids. So already we have seen that proteins and lipids are produced by the endoplasmic reticulum. Then transporting these proteins and lipids is the function of these Golgi bodies. So these Golgi bodies, they packages, they transfers the substances inside the cell wherever it requires. It plays major role in production of lysosomes also. We'll see what are the lysosomes next. It is involved in the synthesis or and secretion of hormones and enzymes also. The materials synthesized near the ER, that is the endoplasmic reticulum, is packaged and dispatched to the various targets inside or outside the cell, as well as it functions include the storage, modification and packaging of the products in the vesicles, and in some complex in some cases the complex sugar also get converted into the simple sugars by these Golgi bodies. So number of Golgi bodies also varies from cell to cell. So what is the function of the Golgi bodies we have seen? So whatever the proteins and lipids which are produced by the endoplasmic reticulum to transfer them or to package them, to modify them and to dispatch them to the various places or to the various targets inside or outside the cell. This is the function of the Golgi bodies. Then let's move on to the lysosomes. We know that generally there are 37,000 billions of chemical reactions that are happening inside the cell every second. And most of these reactions, they form some useful things as a product. But also with these useful things, they produced some of the waste. And they also produce the waste. Now, what will happen if this waste hangs around the cell? So obviously, it is harmful for the cell. It may destroy the cell or it may destroy the activities which are taking place inside the cell. Therefore, this will learn about the waste disposal system of the cell, that is known as the lysosomes. The meaning of lysosome first we'll understand. Lysis means breaking down and soma means body. So lysosomes, they breaking down the waste and hence it keeps the cell clean. These lysosomes are membrane bound sacs filled with the digestive enzymes. These enzymes are made of the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Lysosomes are a kind of waste disposal system of the cell. These helps to keep the cell clean by digesting any foreign material as well as worn out cell organelles. For example, the bacteria or the food which are harmful for the cell, if they entered the cell, the lysosomes, they destroy that bacteria or the harmful food. Then they can also break the complex substances into the simpler substances. They are able to do this because of the presence of the digestive enzyme, which is very powerful and which is capable of breaking down all these organic materials. And during the disturbance in cell metabolism, it also helps. For example, when the cell gets damaged, then can these lysosomes, can they destroy the own cell? So yes, these can destroy their own cell. The lysosomes may burst and the enzyme which is present in them, they digest their own cell, and therefore the lysosome is also known as the suicide bags of a cell.